I'm going to show you the best ways that you can get XP and also complete quests on the Hypixel server in order to gain a higher level overall, and we're starting right now. So first of all, let's talk about what quests are. So quests are basically these little challenges and stuff like that that you have to complete in order to gain a reward of usually some in-game coins, other various game rewards, and of course, Hypixel experience. So the quests can be split into daily quests and weekly quests. The daily quest by a skilled player can be completed in about 1 to 5 games, whereas the weekly quests are a little bit more hard to manage and usually take a couple days or 1 hour or so of grinding the game mode in order to receive them. Generally, you shouldn't focus on grinding weekly quests in one day unless you're trying to focus on some other stats of the game mode that you're getting these quests in. There are also challenges that can be found on the bottom of the GUI of the Questmaster. You receive 10 challenges every day and you can complete them for a total of about 30,000 Hypixel experience, which is a very nice reward. Generally, you'd want to complete these 10 challenges in a game mode that you're comfortable in order to receive the challenges more often and more frequently. Now, why would you want to get a higher Hypixel level? Well, there are various reasons. First of all, from levels 1 to 100, there is a new reward that you can receive for every single level. However, when you pass level 100, there become veteran rewards, which are harder to get and are only received every 10 levels. Keep in mind that when you reach these higher levels, it is much harder to receive XP and level up as frequently as you did around level 1 and level 2. Another benefit of having a higher Hypixel level is that if you're an MVP Plus or an MVP Plus+, you can change the color of your Plus, which usually designates how long you've been playing on the Hypixel network or how experienced you are at games. For instance, a player with a black MVP Plus will generally be considered to be more skillful than a player with just the regular plain red MVP Plus. And finally, as with every other statistic on the Hypixel network, there are also leaderboards that you can grind your Hypixel level on in order to be the highest and the top level on the entire Hypixel network. These are very hard to get to as these players have been playing for years on end, and as you get to these higher levels, they require hundreds and hundreds of thousands of XP. So you generally should not be focusing on grinding out Hypixel level. Now let's get into the grinding part of Hypixel questing. Every single one of these game modes features many quests and challenges that you can complete in order to receive XP. However, some challenges and quests are harder to complete than others and thus should be avoided until the end of questing if necessary. For example, UHC Champions and Megawalls, while they feature multiple quests, these quests will often take multiple games to complete, and the problem with that is that these games can take about like an hour if you play two of them or so, and that is very hard to do while questing. Ideally, you should start your questing in games that are easier to complete, such as Skywars and the arcade games, etc., because these games will require less time to complete and they're thus easier to quest in. You should always quest in the games that take less time to quest in first, because other game modes that take longer will often be more time investing, and you should complete the quests that contain the same amount of XP earlier so that you don't have to worry about them at around 12 o'clock EST when the quests reset. Trust me, I know from experience, I've been completing other quests and then I realized that I haven't completed all my Skywars and arcade quests, so it's like 11:57 and I'm trying to complete every quest, but it's really hard because these quests are like very short, but if you leave yourself not enough time to do them, then you're not going to be able to complete them. So always complete these ones first and you'll always have a better time. The shorter game modes are also greater if you have less time for questing but still want to get a fair amount of Hypixel XP. So let's get started off with the questing. If you're not an MVP Plus or an MVP Plus+, you will have to manually activate your quests, something that I know that a lot of people forget to do because they don't have this auto accept quests feature that a lot of MVP Pluses do. While it is a little unfair, it is, however, just a few clicks of the button, so make sure that you go to the Questmaster first before you actually begin questing, just to make sure that your quests are active. You should also know what the quests and challenges are focusing on, just so that you know what you have to complete while you're questing. This is very useful as there is no in-game feature for you to view what your quests are and how to complete them. Then simply hop into the game and go for those quests. Now that's the very simple way of questing. You just go to the Questmaster, activate your quests, and hop into the game mode and start completing them. However, if you become a more experienced quester or want to grind out more XP in one sitting, then I recommend trying these other tips. Another feature that'll grant you Hypixel XP is the achievement rewards, which will grant you various Hypixel XP rewards for completing achievements. About every 100 points you receive several thousand or several 10,000s of experience points, which are very useful for helping you level up. Achievement points are rewarded by completing various achievements that can be found in almost every Hypixel game. These achievements are split into challenge achievements and tiered achievements. Challenge achievements are usually quite simple and require only one action or so in order to complete them. Tiered achievements, however, are much harder to complete and usually require several days, months, or even years of grinding in order to receive them. For instance, it would probably take you more than one sitting in order to win 1,200 games in team mode. You shouldn't focus on grinding tiered achievement rewards, but rather focus on grinding the challenge achievements because those are easier to complete, whereas the tiered achievements are generally received over grinding game modes over a long period of time. So if you really want to get into experience questing, you should keep in mind what the quests and the challenges are, but you should also keep in mind what achievements are offered in whatever game mode you're playing. Generally, however, if you're questing, you generally want to focus on completing your daily quests and challenges before you start worrying about any achievements. For instance, if I had an achievement that required me to win a game without getting a single kill, I'd probably do the quest to get the kills first before doing a game where I tried to not get any kills. The reason is because these quests are usually a lot easier to complete than most achievements are, and generally, grinding achievement points won't get you the same amount of XP as grinding quests will. So achievement points should just be set off to the side in case something pops up and you have the chance to receive an achievement. Another feature that will help you gain a lot more XP is through joining a guild that has a higher level. The thing about higher level guilds is that you'll have a higher chance of receiving a double XP event in games that you join, which means that the XP that you get at the end of the game will be doubled. Now, while this might be very minuscule and irrelevant, this will stack up over time, and if every single game you got double XP, that means that in the end of the day you will receive double XP from all the games that you played. Questing will also grant guild experience at the end of every game, which will help your guild level up, which will increase the chance of getting double XP in a game. In order to maximize the amount of time that questers get quests completed instead of playing games, questers will often try to complete games in very short amounts of time. So generally, questers tend to quest alone, as questing with friends will generally mean that you'll have to wait on other people to complete their quests before moving on to the next game mode. If you truly want to quest well and efficiently, you won't be spending much time trolling other players and the usual stuff that you do while having fun in Skywars. You should also focus on not taking many risks. For example, if I was questing, I wouldn't go into a 3v1 in hopes of getting a triple kill. I would instead play it safe just so I can complete my win quest near the end of the game. But overall, one of the biggest things you want to have is the mentality of wanting to quest and wanting to get that experience. Because if you don't keep that mentality, you will either get frustrated very easily or just goof off in the game. And true questers generally focus on only getting those quests done and little else. Another thing that questing will have you do is that it'll expose you to many other game modes. For instance, I hadn't played any of the classic games before I started really questing. Then I began playing Quakecraft, Paintball, and Arena Brawl just because those games were short and simple and were very easy to quest in, but I hadn't had much experience with any of them. So while questing, I tried to get better in each of these game modes, and I would actually say I'm a fairly good player in each of these game modes. Because of that, I can quest in these game modes faster and get a fair amount of XP while I'm questing. Unfortunately for most people that play on the Hypixel network, Bedwars is generally not the best game to quest in. There are only two daily quests, and while the weekly quests are simple, they only reward 7,000 Hypixel experience, which is very low for a weekly quest. So if you're looking to really quest and get a higher Hypixel level, maybe skip the Bedwars. If I had to choose a game that's probably the easiest and best to quest in, I would probably choose Skywars, just because there are a plethora of daily quests that are very easy to complete, challenges that are also fairly easy to complete, and the weekly quests are fairly simple and also very easy to complete. They also reward a normal amount of Hypixel experience for daily and weekly quests. Finally, a common misconception I see sometimes when people begin questing is that you should have generosity active when you're questing. Some people believe that generosity will really help you boost up your questing skills, and you should always have generosity active when you're questing. However, it is not as useful as you might think it would be. While you might be able to get various sizes of bags of Hypixel experience with generosity active, it won't reward the same amount of XP you'd get from just normally questing. If you have generosity, I would highly recommend just going into a bigger game such as Mega Walls or UHC and giving the generosity to people there, just so as many people can get XP as possible. And that really about does it for this introduction to questing. This is a very small and easy guide, however, I think I went over the basics of questing, and if you want to begin questing, a lot of this information will help you out greatly. However, keep in mind that a lot of the questing information I've given you in this video has come from me and a bunch of other smaller questers. Everyone will quest differently, and it is up to you to decide what information in this video will help you out, or you should do something else. However, everyone quests differently, so it's up to you if some of the information in this video will help or hinder your ability to quest. If you guys would like to see other questing tips and tricks, such as in various game modes, etc., make sure to leave them down in the comments below, and I might continue this very small series. Anyway, thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys next time. Also, make sure to like and subscribe. I would greatly appreciate it. All right, see you guys. Peace.